Stars fans, we're here in the Dallas Stars locker room with Chris Davidson-Adams, who from this point forward will affectionately be called Critter. Critter is the assistant equipment manager for the Dallas Stars. All right, let's start with the nickname. Everybody's got a nickname around here. Where'd you get Critter?
Well, it was my first couple days in the locker room here with the Stars, and I walked in, and Billy Guerin walked up to me, and he said, "Hey, how you doing? What's your name?" I said, "Chris." And he said, "Well, do you have a nickname?" I said, "Yeah, actually, I do." He said, "Well, your new nickname is Critter." I said, "Okay, no questions asked." And that's, there it was.
All right, so it stuck.
It stuck.
Well,
it's
I
still
know
sticking.
What,
thank
I want to know
Billy
what the original. Garen. I want to know what the original nickname was.
Car bomb.
Car bomb. Obviously, there's a
can't
story.
Can't say bomb on an airplane. You know, it's got a J.
Okay. All right. Is that something growing up? You were like, tinkering an automobile guy or what?
It actually is a drink, and a former teammate of mine gave it to me. So.
You see, here I'm thinking sudsy has to do with washing jerseys. And now that's about something else. And then car bomb is obviously you guys. So I think I know probably what you and sudsy do in your spare time, huh?
Yeah, more laundry.
Exactly. Good point. All right, Critter. So how long have you been with the Dallas Stars?
This is my third year with the Dallas Stars.
And talk about grabbing this gig, because this is a pretty sweet gig. How'd you get this job?
I worked in the minor leagues, and actually Steve called me up after he obtained the head equipment manager position and said they needed a third guy, and I came here and got the job as a third equipment manager, and actually last year I was appointed to the second equipment manager.
Wow. Well, why don't you break down the different levels for us? What does the third guy do, the second guy do, and then the top guy do?
The head equipment manager is in charge of everybody, essentially, and he is in charge of all the ordering and the skates and just making sure everything's going smooth and the budget. And the assistant equipment manager is, that's my position. I do half the skates, a lot of the repairs, making sure everybody in the room is taken care of, they get everything they need, they're all situated. And the third equipment manager also does that, but a lot of, he does most of the visiting room pickups, right, taking care of the visiting room, getting them situated with everything they need.
So basically, once you graduate from the third guy to the second guy, you don't have to deal with the bad guys anymore. It's all about the home team.
You still do, because we're all friends and we help each other out. But
so there is kind of like a brotherhood, a camaraderie between equipment guys around the league.
Yeah, there is. Well, we have a union per se, and we all get together in the summer and check out new equipment and tell stories and around the campfire and that sort of thing.
All right, well, the reason I wanted to really talk to you is because I hear you're the detail guy. You know everything there is to know about all the different players and their quirks and what they expect and what they need in their locker stall. So are you ready?
I think so. Right, Sudsy calls me the equipment nerd, so whatever that is, I guess.
All right, you're equipment geek.
Yeah.
Nerds, like, that's so 1980s.
Yeah.
All right, so I can't help but notice, looking around the room here, that the jerseys are set up in a very special way. The numbers are turned out. Why is it done that way?
I think it looks a lot better and special and neat. I really like things that stand out. I want somebody to walk in our room and look at how everything is set up and just say, wow.
Do you find that you have to be kind of a perfectionist or, dare I say, retentive to be good at this job?
Yeah, I mean, nothing's ever perfect in this world, let alone this game, but, I mean, doesn't mean you can't try.
Let's talk about some of the specific needs for the players. I was at Morning Skate, and I noticed you were discussing certain glove needs. Jeff Halpern, Jussi Jokinen, you're the glove guy. What exactly are players looking for in gloves, and what are you trying to introduce new to the players with gloves?
Guys are looking for comfort and protection. And we're always talking to guys about, you know, comfort and protection, and if they want different alterations, or Jeff is a little bit more particular with his glove. He always wants a little something, but he's very, once he gets into something, he doesn't want to get out of it. So when it's done, it's like taking an old blanket away from a little kid, you know. He just doesn't want to give it up.
Talk about a guy like Jussi Jokinen. I noticed at Morning Skate you were talking to him about gloves. What is it about Jussi and making sure his gloves are right?
The Juice is very particular about his gloves. He always, I actually have to repalm them every week to 2 weeks because he just doesn't think they're adequate. So that process involves taking off the palm and then putting on a new one. But it's a little bit more complicated just because it takes a lot of time and energy and
Now, is that you sitting in front of a sewing machine, or are you doing this by hand? How do you repalm a glove?
Means sitting in front of an industrialized sewing machine for about an hour and 10 minutes.
Like a man sewing machine.
A man sewing machine.
Yeah.
That's how a lot of people think of it, a man sewing machine.
All right, good. All right, let's talk about Trevor Daley, because I see he's got tape for days in his locker. What's up with Dales and the tape?
He likes a lot of tape on his ankles. He always uses black tape, whether we're home or away. He puts it under his socks, so he always uses a lot of black tape. So his request, a lot of black tape.
Like, what's a lot? Like, how many reams?
He uses one roll of clear and three rolls of black, thick.
That's per game?
Per game.
Oh, my gosh. What's your, like, yearly budget for tape?
A lot.
Okay, good answer. Okay, what about a guy, like, goalies? Let's talk goalies. What about a guy, like, the guy that's getting the start tonight, Mike Smith? What does Smitty like in his locker?
Mike Smith likes just a roll of black thick tape to take at home. Roll a white thick on the road. Tape his socks. Sometimes he'll have me wax his stick. And sugarless gum. Extra polar ice.
Extra polar ice sugarless. All right. Remember. And you have to get that for him.
Yep.
Do you have to actually open it up and take it out of the thing?
Yep.
Really?
Yep.
Smitty, come on.
Your job.
All right. The captain, Brendan Morrow, what is he like?
A lot of tape as well. Retapes his stick a lot. He's very anal about his stick. It takes a very long time taping it, but you got to have that perfection sometimes.
Now, I notice guys obviously have their sticks taped a certain way. Some have a grip a certain way. Some have the thickness at the top of the stick a certain way. So you have to memorize like 25 different ways to do sticks.
Yeah, I try. It's very challenging. I'm not always right on like they are, but I get them close as I can.
All right, what about a guy like Mike Madonna? We're standing in front of his locker area, and I noticed some things that are unique to him.
He has a stretching block, some big foam pads he puts in his skates, and a foam pad on the stall so it doesn't hurt his behind when he sits on it.
Really?
Really.
So you've got to supply the softness.
Yes.
All right, is that kind of a... I don't know, is that a health issue or is that just a comfort issue?
Maybe a little bit of both.
What about a guy like Steve Ott? What is Steve Ott like in his stall?
Steve Ott, pretty simple guy. Some clear tape, roll of black, thin to tape his stick, and just ask him where the beach is, he'll tell you.
Obviously, hockey players are superstitious.
Yeah.
They like things the way that they like things, and especially if they win games, they want it to keep going that way.
I actually had a player in the minor leagues who you couldn't touch anything in his stall, no matter what, nothing. Before the game, after the game, and I made that mistake when I was younger and heard about it for a long time.
No, really, you touched his stuff.
Yeah, touched his towel.
Oh, his towel, okay. Since you're a young guy and you are the assistant, do you notice that the rookies kind of come to you first if they've got a problem instead of going to Sudsy? What's the experience like between the rookies and the vets?
I think both of us, Steve and I, are very personable, so there's no preference. I mean, if I'm around, they'll come to me. If he's around, they'll go to him. It doesn't. There's no preference, and everybody's good. Everybody's easy to get along with. So.